Cassandra, it's you!
Phoebe!
You promised we'd see each other again, and now we have!
I also said, stay out of trouble.
Which I have! Okay, almost out of trouble.
I can't believe you're here!
Me either! I can't believe we both made it to Athens. It's so much different from Kefalonia.
But what are you doing here?
I'm here to get you ready. I have to make sure you leave all your weapons and change into these clothes.
So you somehow work here? For Pericles?
No, for Aspasia.
I think I'm ready to go in.
You can't! Not like that, anyway. The Athenians like it best when you try to fit in. But don't worry, I have just the outfit for you.
I'll get changed. Promise you'll take care of my things?
Yep. Leave your weapons in the corner, and I'll come back when you're done.
I feel uncomfortable in this.
Now you look like everyone else.
You say that like it's a good thing.
It is. If you want them to take you seriously, this is the easiest way. Trust me.
Is that everything?
You're all ready to go in. Don't worry. You've done scarier things than this.
I'm struggling to think of any right now. Are you sure I can't keep just one weapon with me?
No weapons. Now hurry and go in. Oh, and don't leave without saying bye.
Here, Cassandra. The mighty mercenary and traveler has finally made her grand entrance. Only slightly late, too.
Herodotus! Athenians have no problem letting me know when I'm not welcome. It's a relief to see your friendly face.
Don't let the company here tonight intimidate you.
I won't.
Pericles is no king. He needs these guests to love him so that the people love him. And they, in turn, need Pericles. You're no different from any of them.
Do you really think these people will help me?
They will if you get them to trust you. And you've wisely dressed for the occasion. Appearing trustworthy is the most important part of being trusted, after all. Now then, come, let me introduce you to everyone. They may not look it, but this group holds the way to the future on the tip of their opinionated tongues. Ah, Sophocles and Euripides, for example. Two of the most celebrated playwrights to date. No one can throw stones as far as they can. They appear to be locked in some kind of intellectual struggle, as is their way.
He's a writer of comedies, of all things. Comedies, Euripides!
I've heard of Sophocles. In my line of work, it pays to know who the richest and most famous men are.
Hermippos has also written his fair share of comedies. You should drink more. Lately, his attitudes have garnered him more notice than his works. However, the fellow beside him, Protagoras, is a sophist worthy of as much praise as the great Socrates himself.
Inviting Socrates seems like a good way to ruin everyone's night. I'm surprised they would let him in the door.
Oh, don't let Socrates get under your skin. At least he wore shoes for the occasion. And the poor thing gesticulating like an ape is Thrasymachus. If you listen closely, you'll notice he and Socrates are actually arguing the same points. But the wind from his wild gestures deafens him to critique.
That isn't at all what I mean.
Where is Pericles?
Oh, he never attends his own parties. Which reminds me, there's something I need to get his help with.
Vile Socrates! Always appearing where I least expect him. Warrior, protect me from his amorous gaze. Oh, Alcibiades, this is not a time for jealousy, but for love.
Let's not use Alcibiades as an example. be good, and don't drink too much. So, tell me, what does a Mystios like you think of a party like this?
This is going to be a long night. Party should be about vomiting up blood, not vomiting up poetry. These people are so clean.
If these guests aren't to your own unique tastes, then just focus on why you came here in the first place.
Thank you, Herodotus.
Now, if you'll excuse me, Pericles is here somewhere, and I need to prepare him. If he's alone, I'll tell him what your brother said.
Agreed. Pericles needs to know. I'll stay here and look for clues.
I hope they know something about your mother.
Me too.
I suppose you've come in here to mock me for my fight with Euripides.
I've seen lots of fights. That wasn't one.
I really made a fool of myself this time, didn't I? I'm Sophocles, though I'm sure you knew that. And you are?
I am looking for information that'll help me find someone. A Spartan woman.
A Spartan woman in Athens. Sounds intriguing. Though, if you expect me to notice someone other than myself, you expect too much. You could talk to Euripides. He's the second most worldly man here. That pediculous, Xanthodontus exothalmic Morosov. But he doesn't talk without a drink.
I have no idea what that meant.
No, you don't.
So we get him drunk and he talks. He sounds more Argive than Athenian.
Impressive, foreigner. Euripides is from Argos.
All right. If nothing else, this party could use the help.
You'll need to pick the right wine for this task. The kitchen should have what you need. Let me know when Euripides is done in, and I'll slip away unseen.
I'll get the wine.
Wonderful. Now, if you want some friendly advice, Aristophanes cannot stand sweet wine. I've seen what it can do to him. Absolutely, horrifyingly delightful.
It wouldn't be a party without someone losing their stomach. I'll let you know if your plan worked.
Say for that arrogant playwright. I don't see many distinguished guests in here. Can I help you with something?
I'm here for your sweet wine.
Yes, take it. But get out of my kitchen. I'm very busy, you know.
A new face in Pericles' abode! Ha! That in itself is a remarkable thing. You must have seen me doing my impression of Cleon. I call it the Orange Ape. Tell me, what does it think?
I am called many things. It isn't one of them.
What do you call yourself then, creature of many names?
Cassandra.
I wouldn't peg you as a Cassandra, but never mind. I'm Aristophanes, and this man is Euripides. Oh, go on, introduce yourself.
I'm Euripides.
For a playwright, you're not much for words.
Good men lead quiet lives, as old Euripides likes to say. Don't you, Euripides?
When I need to relax, I start a fight. For you, though.
Quickly! Bring him some wine so that he might say something clever.
After my argument with Sophocles, I think I'd rather keep my head clear.
I'm Pericles' new servant. I'd be happy to bring some wine.
An Athenian servant, you. And these are wine-pouring muscles.
I was a rower on Pericles' ship, where he took pity on me. Now I pour wine for people who question my word. And his.
I wasn't questioning. Perhaps one drink.
Let's conjure Dionysos, shall we?
This is pure swill,
amateur.
In my day, this would be considered nectar of the gods. Another round!
Ready for more? Yeah, I can hardly stomach this pig's piss.
I could outdrink both of you with one hand. Let's have some more.
You ready for another?
This wine is terrible.
You, I like you. Who brought you here?
I brought myself. I'm on the trail of a woman who fled Sparta a long time ago.
Fled? Why?
She lost two children. She had no choice.
She fled to heal a broken heart. Euripides, write her into a play.
I've heard Spartan mothers go to a sanctuary in Argolis to beg Asclepios for his divine pity. I should know, it's my home.
After what she went through, I'm not sure she'd trust priests.
Then she sought my friend, Hippocrates. He's a physician, best of the best. He still keeps his office in Argos. If she went to him for help, there's no doubt he'd have given it.
I love getting drunk and singing. Come back if you want to sing with me.
I'll think about it. Hippocrates in Argos. Here I come.
How's Euripides? Drunk, I hope.
You can stop hiding in here. Euripides won't notice you coming out. He won't notice anything.
Hiding? Heed this. War has come to Athens. First they take our homes, then they take our heads. I intend to be found with at least my dignity intact. Or what's left of it anyway. If you see Pericles, tell him I said thank you for another colorful evening.
Someone's being hurt. Open this door or I'll kick it in!
Don't mind her. She likes to watch. Look at you. Such authority. Such aggression. I can see why Pericles has taken such an interest in you. Did you come to join us?
It sounded like someone was in pain.
Well, it can sometimes be hard to distinguish between sounds of pleasure and pain. Had I known you were going to knock, I would have left my door wide, wide open for you.
I only came to this symposium to find someone.
Sounds like we can help each other then, doesn't it? You fetch us a bit of oil, I help you find who you're looking for. Maybe they're in here.
She's not in there.
I think I'll check all the same.
I come bearing gifts.
We're saved! Today, these women grieved for their sons. And these men worked the wall. But tonight, we forget all of that. Let's have some fun! What do you say? Care to join us?
Now, it's time for you to help me, Ali. I'm looking for someone.
All business right until the end. I like that.
Focus. I'm looking for a woman who fled Sparta a long, long time ago.
Fled Sparta? No one flees Sparta. But let's pretend she did. If she were stupid, she'd be dead. If she were smart, she'd do what Aspasia did. She'd earn her independence. The smartest and most resourceful women I've ever met have been in Corinthia.
The Athera? I've heard they play some sort of role in Corinth, but I assumed it was the same as any other city.
Oh, no. These women are unlike any other you'll meet. A force. And the only ones there with any smarts.
Ali! Come back inside!
Ooh, the celebration continues. When you reach Corinth, find Anthusa. No one goes in or out of the city without her knowing. Until we meet again, warrior.
Anthusa in Corinth. It's not much, but it's a start.
Yes.
If it isn't the one who agrees that knowledge is most important.
I think we agreed our use of that knowledge couldn't be more different.
You remember. Perhaps our conversation can continue.
You really intend to use this young destruction to avoid the point being argued?
If you've been arguing this long and you haven't agreed yet, just give up.
We're discussing the nature of rules. Where better to do so than here? I'll ask you the same question I asked Thrasymachos. Would you agree that the act of ruling is an art?
It is an art, as all worthy undertakings are. That is not up for argument.
Yet, medicine is for the betterment of the patient, and not the physician. Carpentry improves the building, not the builder. Then, is the art of ruling not for the betterment of the ruled rather than the ruler?
Don't be absurd!
I've seen enough of the world to know that there are no just rulers. Even Pericles is self-serving.
Is a Spartan general who brings order to his troops, thereby saving his own life, self-serving? I'm not sure that's the case.
Ruling a city and fighting in battle are different things.
By practicing the art of war, doesn't the general guarantee some of his troops a ferry ride to Hades, when a swift retreat would save all their lives?
You just said a general isn't self-serving when he brings order to his troops. Then you said he is self-serving because retreating would save the lives of his men? What are you trying to say?
I never tried to say anything.
But you just said those things.
I said the words, but I didn't say anything at all. I only attempted to gain your view on the matter.
You're wasting your time.
Aspasia.
I couldn't help but notice your talent for debate. Well done.
Socrates is an interesting character.
Ah, Phoebe. Pericles has retired to the balcony already, has he? His ability to sneak off and sulk is second to none.
I can go get him, and Cassandra can help. Everyone listens when she talks.
That'll be fine. Run along. Cassandra will be right behind you. Now, allow me to introduce myself. My name is Aspasia. I had to go to great lengths to cover up your work in Megaris.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Oh, now. To convince someone in this house, even your eyes must tell a lie.
Fine, it was me. But my actions were personal, not political.
We do what we must to survive, and there's no shame in that. It's how you got here. How I got here. The clothes, they fit you well, I trust.
These may be the nicest clothes I've ever worn, but I feel a bit uncomfortable, to be honest.
You never really get used to them. It seems we have the attention of the entire room without a single eye being fixed on us. If you'd like to talk, do it now, and do it discreetly.
I've been searching for a woman named Mirini, my mother. I think she may be in danger, and my search brought me here.
What clues do you have to her whereabouts?
A physician named Hippocrates may have seen her in Argos.
He's a good man. If you find a woman named Agathe there, do let her know Aspasia sends her regards. What else?
Alcibiades gave me the name of a woman in Corinth.
I'm sure he did. My dear friend, Anthusa, is the only one I know who's enjoyed a life in Corinth through legitimate means. Mostly legitimate, anyway.
That's all I have.
There is another option. In a former life, when I needed something done or someone found, I contacted a friend. An admiral of a sort.
What's his name?
Her name is Xenia. When we last spoke, she was in chaos. A word of caution. When you go to her, be on your guard. Sea life makes a monster out of most people.
Thank you, Aspasia.
When you're done, return here. Together, we will find who you're looking for. Now do me a favor and get Pericles to come down here and greet his guests.
Perhaps later. First, explain to me your point.
Cassandra!
I didn't send for you. No matter how you've dressed for my party, Phoebe shouldn't have let you in.
Aspasia told me to come find you. She wants you to come down to the party.
She says I don't interact with our guests enough. But these parties aren't for me. Technically, you're a guest. If you join Herodotus and me, that should be enough for her, don't you think?
You really don't want to go downstairs, do you?
When your days are spent speaking in front of crowds, you begin to crave these moments of silence.
Or as silent as I let it be, at least.
Your life is in danger.
Yes, yes, Herodotus was saying. This cult doesn't worry me. I have my life threatened by far worse people every day. My true concern is Athens. I fear for her future.
The Spartans aren't your real concern, Pericles. The cult is coming, and they're bringing their strongest weapon.
Listen to her, Pericles.
The Spartans are immediate. A cult's threat is ambiguous.
I'm related to one of the cult members, and I believe him when he says they're coming after you.
Sound counsel to consider. I'll be sure to let my men know, regardless.
Aspasia sent me to see what's taking you so long.
Tell Aspasia I'll be right there. I suppose this is where our conversation ends. Thank you again for helping me. I hope my guests are able to help you in your search.
Time will tell.
Tired.
Only of conversation. I think that's the most talking I've ever done.
See? You didn't need the weapon after all. Are you leaving?
I've had enough Athenian hospitality to last me a lifetime.
You get used to it. It's nice. What are you going to do now?
There's a woman on the island of Chaos that I need to meet. I think I'll head there first.
I've heard there are pirates there.
I'll be sure to be careful.
Good. Before you go, I heard something from Aspasia. About Kefalonia.
What is it?
She said there was some sort of plague. You don't think... My friend, the blood fever.
Don't think like that. Whatever happened on Kefalonia isn't our fault. I'll go myself and find out if this plague even happened, okay?
Okay. Thanks. I knew I could count on you.
Not going to beg to come along this time?
Nope. I'm happy here. And this isn't Kefalonia. That means you'll be back.
That's very true.
Plus, I really like working for Aspasia. She says she has a mission for me.
I'll see you soon, Phoebe.
Bye, Cassandra!